Hey there, folks, this is Matt, and welcome back to Steam Cleaning. It's 31 different games in 31 mostly different days during the month of March. We're going to play another game tonight. According to Steam, played a little bit of Dynamite Jack last night. It was pretty all right. Tonight, I'm going to put my brain to the test and play Puzzle Agent. All right, admin prompt. That's what I'm talking about. I was waiting for one of these to happen. Let's install some stuff. Let's do something. Video game. We got going on. Whoa. Okay. Hot audio coming out these. 10 years old. Oh boy. Nelson Tethers, Puzzle Agent. Okay. I'm gonna assume. Oh. Sure. That all sounds good. Nothing showing up. Well, did I break it? Uh-oh. I don't think it liked that resolution for some reason. Yeah, I think it's bleeding over. Oh dear. Is bad. Well. I think it done crashed. Like, hard crashed. Like, I gotta open up. I can't even get into Task Manager. That's not good. Old video games. Old video games. I might need to. I don't know why this is doing this. Hang on. What are we looking at over here? Okay. We'll try this again. I do have backup games in case things don't work. Okay. I think that might be it. Play game. Go with slot number one. Press play to start a new game. Look at that guy. Okay. Audio seems super hot. Is it loud? Do I need to adjust it on my end? I need to switch back here. For sure. It just seems very loud. This is 2010. When did Walking Dead come out? 2012? I guess that would have been the beginning of the end of Telltale. What is going on here? There's a spaceman in the office! Calm down. Breaking. That's the weirdest and easiest looking Rubik's Cube. Okay. This is just Professor Layton. Thankfully, all this stuff snaps together, makes it much easier. I do it! Ow? Okay, sure. Okay.
What's up, Pop?
Hi! Puzzle Research, this is Agent Tethers.
There's voice acting.
I think you have the wrong number. Oh, I see. An assignment.
Thinking, man.
In the field? No, sir, it's just, it's been, yes, quite some time.
You mean 1 week?
Erasers? The foundation of democracy? Oh, absolutely, sir, I agree, sir. Oh, yes, the White House needs its erasers, sir. I'll be on the next plane to... Wait, where?
Goggins? Googans? Goggins. God. This is some animation. Is this running right? I mean, it does have a better and more consistent frame rate than most of their adventure games. Boom! But this really is just a Professor Layton-like, isn't it? I'm gonna do some stuff, and then I'm gonna solve a puzzle, and then I'm gonna do some stuff and solve a puzzle, and do some stuff and solve a puzzle.
Just arrived in Scoggins, Minnesota.
Not a real place!
Population, 754. Temperature,
cold.
It's cold, and not much to look at. According to the agency, there's some kind of thing going on at the local eraser factory. The whole plant is shut down.
Local eraser factory in Scoggins, Minnesota.
Hopefully this won't be a big waste of time.
Still, the animation is intentional.
Agent
okay,
Tether's
so
out.
Game appears to be running correctly. Thanks, chat.
I have no idea where my hotel is. I might have to ask for directions.
Do I talk to the creepy old man by clicking on him?
Excuse me, I'm Nelson Tethers with the FBI's Department of Puzzle Research.
Voice actor sounds
Hello?
Really
okay.
familiar.
Okay, and you are?
Bjorn.
Bjorn?
Yeah.
Nice to meet you, Mr. Bjorn. Boy, those snowmobiles sure are a bumpy ride, eh?
Yeah.
Can you give me directions to the nearest hotel? I'm having a little trouble finding my way around.
You'd never get there. Road sucked too slick.
Sir, I'm an agent of the FBI's Puzzle Research Division.
Ah, the PRD.
It can't be harder than the puzzles I see every day.
Not so.
It's really just a matter of trajection.
Okay, on the way to the hotel, you're going to pass two traffic lights.
Range locks to help. Okay. All right. That's why he sounds familiar. The announcer from the Sam and Max games. I never played BioShock 2. I need to play that at some point. I'm a BioShock Infinite apologist. I like that game a lot. The original one is good up until the twist. And then after the twist, it really went downhill. Alright. Back to the turn. Must hit every stoplight on his way. Alright, so we need to get you from here to here. So you're gonna head this way and then dink. And then. All right. So if I work back. No, that. 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 The whole dude. Minerva's Den is better. The Xbox game room is the best. I don't know. The game room quick looks are special. Let's put it that way. I'm going to say this is it, even though I might be wrong. Okay, I think that'll do it. Don't worry, I won't trick any of you into watching me play Game Room on Xbox. Alright. It was the other way around. One of the episodes of the Game Room Quick Look very clearly has Jeff and Ryan talking about Minerva's Den, and he pretty much goes, "Nah, dude, we're playing Game Room."
Must have gotten lost.
And then Ryan goes into a bunch of expletives that I won't repeat here, but in general, it's pretty awesome. Then there was another episode where they quit Game Room early, and Jeff paid for and downloaded Sonic Adventure when that came out for the 360, and then immediately says that he hates Sonic Adventure. So, you know, I've watched the entire Game Room Quick Look a few too many times.
I'm here to investigate an incident at the Scoggins Eraser.
It's really
factory.
A good.
Do you know anything about it?
If you look at it from like a documentary standpoint, a very good look at the downward spiral that Jeff goes through the entire year.
Seen any suspicious people hanging around the hotel lately?
Yep.
Really?
Around?
Can you describe them?
Skinny. Asks lots of questions. There's a stupid.
Yeah, he also did not like Sonic 4 Episode 1, a game I've never played.
Yep.
A game that I own on Steam. Same. Goodbye. Inspect the fence. There are bite marks taken out of the fence?
Discovered a fence. Boards all chewed up, something terrible. Could be the work of strays trying to get to the dumpsters back there.
I mean, I have hundreds of Steam games. And there are Saturdays during this month. And there are Sonic games that I haven't played. I'm just saying. Inside the hotel. Just saying. Gnomes! Oh, this guy. This guy. Right? This. These things, whatever they are, they stand out. Hey, people want to start buying me games on Steam. I'm not going to say no. Oh, if I just click somewhere, it'll tell me what I can do. I can talk to you, or I can.
Well, these are interesting.
They're gnomes.
Those are Scoggins gnomes. All the tourists love them. But I think one has gone missing. I swear.
Is that Minnesota or is that Canada? I can't tell.
I took a picture when I set it up, but I guess I lost it. I still have the film negative, though.
Oh, boy. Okay. But the negative's going to be flipped. Oh, man. Okay. All right, so let's start by... Oh, all right. So I want one that's facing right with a green hat. And all right, so that one is that one. And I want one that's facing left. So that's that. Okay. And then I've got... Alright, so these I can rule out because that... So it's one of... It's this one, or this one. Alright. I've got a facing right and a facing left. The hand up in the front. So I got... I think it's this one. That one's facing back, like that guy. And that one's facing the opposite of that. So these match. It's gotta be that one. Yeah, there we go.
One of your
puzzle it out in the old brain here. Where's all the matchstick puzzles?
That be something?
Hello.
Well, hello there, mister. Welcome to Valda's Inn. I'm Martha Garrett, but everyone calls me Ma. How can I help you?
I'm Nelson Tethers. I have a reservation.
Oh, yeah. You're here about the eraser factory, eh? We're awfully excited to have a real FBI man in our town. It's just like TV, yeah?
Ooh, just like
I'm
the X-Files.
Make some hot dish for you later.
A hot dish?
Oh, you'll love it. I've never met a man who didn't love himself some hot dish.
Okay. Explain to an East Coaster what hot dish actually is.
So, what room am I in?
Yeah, okay. I've got your room right here. Oh, dear. This is so embarrassing.
Casserole. That doesn't narrow it down
room
enough.
Number in code.
Mind if I have a look? I bet I can figure out what room I'm in.
Okay. That just looks like it says 9. Variety of casserole, very loose. That just looks like it says 9. I'm going with 9. Doing all right. We're getting these easy puzzles.
Oh, yeah, now I see. Okay, then. Here's your room key, FBI man.
FBI man.
Thanks. Actually, while I have you here, do you mind if I ask you a couple questions? Real quick, I promise.
Oh, yeah, of course.
So you do mind? Well. I don't know. I think FBI man might be a little bit better than some of these robot masters I've run into and, Mega Man X3.
How do I get to the factory from here?
You don't.
The FBI doesn't know where the factory is? Oh dear, our moose is cooked.
Rest assured, ma'am, the FBI just likes to confirm intelligence with civilian knowledge of We like to double check things.
Oh, of course. Well, it's easy. I have a tourist map of our little town of Scoggins right here. You know, our Scoggins erasers is the plant that supplies the
fish.
White House
okay.
with all of its erasers. The president could
well,
be
two things that were called fish. One was clearly
Scoggins
a fish. The other one was a
right
crustacean,
now.
I believe.
Yes, ma'am. That's why I'm here. That and the fact that every time the Bureau made an inquiry
right next
into the situation, all we ever got back were bizarre
a nice
puzzles.
Rub-a-down.
Oh, yeah. Well, that'll happen.
I'm waiting for her to just jump into the chair.
Do you know anything about the problem at the factory?
Yeah, so tragic about the accident, huh?
Accident?
Oh, yeah, the foreman, Isaac Davner, they say he was killed in there.
That seems bad.
So? Well, not to be gossipy, but I heard the accident was caused by raccoons.
Raccoons?
Yeah, little creatures that live in the woods around the factory.
Oh.
Maybe you should go talk to Sheriff Fogg about it, though. You should be able to catch him out by the factory right now.
Okay, I'll do that. Thank you. The guy in the lobby, is he okay?
Oh, that's Bo Murphy. He's always been a bit of an odd
What's
one.
Up, Big Bo?
Yeah, he sits there all day trying to do his puzzles. He mostly keeps to himself, and I bring him some food from time to time. Sometimes I swear he'd starve to death if I didn't bring him something to eat.
Thanks. Well, goodbye.
Enjoy your stay.
Oh, that reminds me. Do you have any gum for sale? Or know where I can buy some?
Dear, we've been out of gum for quite some time.
What?
Haven't seen a stick in months anywhere in town. We tend to get shipments of things like that in the spring.
So, no gum?
Nope.
Gum helps me concentrate.
Well, ABC gum? Re-chewed gum. I mean, I don't chew gum as it is, but
excuse me, you look perplexed.
Puzzles. So many puzzles.
I found
puzzles?
Waldo.
I might be able to help you with that.
Okay. Tapeworms seem bad. Oh no. Alright. Yeah. Everything lines up here. This just kind of runs off through there. That looks right. That looks righter. Go with this, because that this seems a little off, but this part looks okay. This right here looks wrong, but everything else looks like it lines up pretty well. I do have the thing with two heads here. I don't think I want that, right? I wouldn't want something with two heads. Do I want something with two heads? That's probably right. I feel like I should be able to get a rubber band out of this, right? This appears to be a rubber band now. Everything else looks like worms. Killed that. Yeah!
Maybe you can relax a little.
With the whispers, if it's an acrostical enigma, maybe it's a Baltimore transdeletion. The whispers?
Or not. Got any more puzzles you need help with?
Puzzles? No new puzzles yet.
Okay.
Brain's always thinking about puzzles.
I'll just check in on you later.
The door? Okay. Go in the door. Screwdriver.
Someone left a screwdriver in the alley beside the hotel.
Flathead.
Looks clean. Probably of no consequence.
Then pick it up.
Someone left. Looks.
Puzzle.
Winner undeclared in local contest.
Alright. It's one of these. Okay. Alright, so you beat You lost the flow. But you beat flow, okay. So you won. You won? Also, shouldn't the exclamation point be inside the quotation marks? But all right, I would guess one of these two. I would guess this, making you flow, but I'm also a little confused right now. Let me see. This sounds like it's a concession to whoever won. What does chat say? I think it's this. I'm just going to go with I could choose some gum. I don't want to do that. Is it better to chew gum or is it better to retry the puzzle? What? Yeah. In the interest of time, I'm gonna go with I wanna go here. Okay. That's just those four statements. Going here. All right. Took a while, but we got it. I want to see this. Fair enough. That was kind of my logic.
That was a tricky one.
Sure was, Nelson. Yeah, okay. I'm a PPS.
The residents of Skagen seem nice enough. Aside from one wild goose chase, everyone's been cooperative. Plus, it looks like I'm primed for all the hot dish I can eat. It remains to be seen if that's a good thing. I got a map from the hotel owner, so I'm heading over to the eraser factory. Agent Tethers out. Am I supposed to be saying that?
Get on the snowmobile. Okay, there's places to go. Look at this doofus.
Hi, Sheriff Bog. Yeah, I'm Nelson Tethers of the FBI's Department of Puzzle.
Agent Tethers, good to meet you.
That's not the voice I expected to come out of this guy.
Yes, we do.
We do?
Oh, yes. It's going to be a while before we can get this factory running again.
But my job is to get this factory back to making erasers.
Agent Tethers, you're in a right pickle.
Well, I should probably ask you some questions about the incident, then.
That's what I'd do if I was a big, important FBI boy.
What was this incident?
Well, we don't need to be dramatic.
What happened?
There was an
traditional
explosion.
Top layer
what?
Of hot dish is
oh,
either
yeah.
Tater tots
big
or lo mein noodles. Those are not remotely
home.
Close to each other.
When did the accident take place?
Well, I've been trying to figure that out myself. Here's what I know.
Watch over the factory from midnight to midnight. Time of the big noise. Of course only Bernie would put in the full effort. Of course. Of course. Alright, so... Alright, so Bernie put in 8. And then... Pop put in 3, that's 11, meaning there's 13 left. So if you work from 6 till you were relieved, that doesn't help. Actually, write something down. Pop and Iggy. Of course there would be Pop and Iggy. Yeah, sure as shit. I think I'm going to have to get up because I just heard a noise in the background that is making me very, very concerned. Hang tight. So, directly above me is my loft, where my television is, along with my receiver. And occasionally, for no specific reason that I can fathom, my receiver turns on and off by itself. It's not connected to the network. No one's hitting a remote. It just thinks that there's a signal coming from the television. It turns on, And about 10 seconds later, it turns off. And then I hear the clicking. And it's frustrating. Hey! Of course you know that. My receiver with all the busted HDMIs that I still use. Do you know the answer to this puzzle? Alright, let me try to think with my brain again. 1 hour before the last shift started, so I just have to figure out who did the last shift. And then I can figure out who was there. We're just trying to figure out when it happened, right? Like, who was working? Oh. So midnight to midnight, right? Chat is guessing 4. Okay. Midnight to midnight. Okay. So we would go from midnight to 1 hour before the last shift started. So the last shift would be 5 to midnight, which would be 7 hours. Yeah, okay. Alright, so you were, so if Iggy was relieved and he worked from 6 until whenever, then he wasn't the last shift. Right? Or not necessarily. Chat's just messing with me now. Alright, so... Yeah, it's a 24-hour period. We know for a fact that Bernie did 8 and Pop did 3. Which means, by my math, there's 13 hours left. Someone had started at midnight. Yeah, I know you're trying to work your way through it. I'm trying to work my way through it. Yeah, so it could be midnight to 3. And then 3 to 11. But if he's saying boom 1 hour before the last shift started, how would he know that? Unless that was when he was working. So. Yeah. Alright, so. We just need to figure out who put in the last shift. It's either Pop or Al because Iggy said he was relieved. So, the last shift being 3 hours would mean that it went off at 8, which means you would have started at noon. And then if you worked from 6 until you were relieved, you could have worked from 6 to noon, and you could have worked from midnight to 6. It doesn't say that they can't. No, I think I'm doing that wrong, right? That doesn't. No, that's not right. That's not right. That's not right. The last shift was 3. No, it could have been at 8. I think it could have happened at 8. Then you put in your full 8. So you, 1. So you would have worked from 1 to 9. Okay. And you worked from 6 until you were relieved, so you could have worked from 6 to 1, and then you could have worked from... I'm going to go with 8. I'm thinking... But how would Al know that only Bernie put in the full 8 hours if he worked before him? Oh, these puzzly things. All right. I don't want to do it. I'm gonna hint. I still feel like it's 8. Still feel like it's 8 based on the information that's here. Let's check this again. From their statements, can you determine the time of the big noise? What's up, big noise? All right, so if Al was the only shift after Bernie's, that would mean... All right, so if we started with Pop and he did 3 hours, that's in here. So that wouldn't work. So you worked from 6 until you were relieved. And you couldn't have worked 8, you could only have worked 7. I'm going with 8. I'm just going with 8 with no hints. Yeah, there we go. Tried to put too much logic into it, I think. Had to start at 6 a.m. because we were relieved by another guard. Al came first and worked 6 hour shift. Okay, yeah. Right.
If there was an explosion at that time, wouldn't the icicles on the building have been knocked off?
Good point. Maybe they grew back.
What happened to the foreman? My notes don't have a lot of details.
Well, we're still trying to figure that out. One day after work, Mr. Dabner just never came home. The accident was pretty bad.
Oh, is there a...
The Flyers fan is still watching. How bad are they losing? Gone. Aren't they playing
Andrew
in Carolina
Dabner's
tonight?
His name, if you don't have that in your notes.
We don't even know if he died in that explosion?
Won't be able to find that out till we find a way into the factory.
Can't you just knock everything down?
What did your investigation turn up?
Not much. I can't figure out how to get past this lock.
Well, that's because it's missing a piece. I can see that just by looking at it.
So it is. I guess that's why you make the big bucks, right?
That's right, sir.
I guess I need to find a thing. Up to nothing.
Well, I don't seem to be getting
okay,
a lot of answers.
Okay, I'll take up to nothing.
Listen. Why don't you meet me down at the Moose Ear Diner later? I have some files related to the case that you might be able to help me with.
Oh, you mean puzzles?
Okay, but I really think...
Agent Tethers, it's a pleasure working with you. You're doing a great job. Meet you at the Moose Ear in a bit.
Oh, he's booking. I guess we can look at this, but I need a gear. The game is in Philly. I thought they were in Carolina. My bad.
The factory are very locked. Some sort of custom-built contraption has got this place locked up tighter than Fort Knox. The The device seems damaged, though. It seems to be missing a piece.
Okay. I don't think there's anything else for me to click on, so I should probably just leave. Are we going to the diner? Okay, go to the diner. Ah, yes, Luke Fisk. Gum. Any other gums? No? No. Hi.
Excuse me.
Osher would be very unhappy with you.
Is it safe for me to go into the diner? Excuse me.
Gotta fix the sign.
By banging on it with a wrench.
Something wrong with your sign? I said, is there something wrong with...
You a cop? I ain't got time for cops.
I'm not a cop.
Look, I gotta get this.
You work for the FBI. You're essentially a cop.
I don't want to be out here.
You're a very well-dressed cop.
If you know what I mean.
I don't, actually. What do you mean by that?
It's just a fuse, but I can't remember which one it is. Not with all the whispers in the head.
What? Whispers?
Get the fuse for me. I'm getting cold out here.
Use it completes the sequence. You got it. Oh. 1, 2, 3. That one was easy. That was a visual one.
That should do it.
Hey, what do you know? This ought to keep the little buggers away.
Little what?
Buggers.
Well, I gotta finish getting this sign mounted. See you later. Well... we'll see.
I don't suppose you know anything about the eraser factory accident?
Don't suppose I do.
All right.
Did you know Isaac Davner?
Not much. Heard he had some kind of accident. Feel bad for his wife, Glory. Such a pretty girl.
I should really talk to her. Do you know where I can find her?
Yes, I do.
So, where can I find her?
Inside.
Okay.
Goodbye.
Oh, boy. Right.
There's some tobacco on the counter. It smells like cherry. I guess the waitress hasn't been in much of a cleaning mood lately.
Just stand right there. Wow. All right, there's a lot of stuff to do. We can talk. Fuck you.
Hi there. I'm Agent Tethers with the FBI. Sir, you seem stressed. Do you know something about the factory you'd like to let me in on?
I don't know anything.
Sir, it's against the law to withhold information or lie to a federal agent.
Yeah, I'm into some stuff.
Yeah, I'm into some stuff is probably not something you would want to say to a cop. But...
so, what's your name?
Steve.
Sir, I'm here about the factory. If you've got nothing to do with it, then however you spend your time doesn't concern me.
Stuff!
There's nothing you can tell me about the factory.
I don't co-mingle with the factory folk.
You haven't heard about anything suspicious going on, have you?
Nothing more than usual.
Okay. Stuff!
What stuff are you into?
I airlift wooden gnomes out of Scoggins. With birds.
To where? Why? How?
Black market trinket rings. Big money.
Couldn't you just use the mail?
Number of gnomes. Okay. Each bird has a certain weight limit. Each bird is shown carrying the maximum amount that it can, or if they team up on heavy loads. Okay. Oh no. No, no, no. Okay. Total. Okay. Alright. You have two, which means one per leg. That's one. Two. And you're two per leg? Looks like. That's one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Did that math very quickly. Oh. All right. Okay. Just one and two, right? Wow. They don't even tell you how. They just... Nope, that's it. You figured it out.
Another puzzle solved.
We can talk to you again.
How are you doing, Steve?
Oh, more puzzles. Okay. Where are we
out at? Of curiosity,
almost an hour.
Anything else you want to tell me about these birds?
They're smart. I once saw a black-bellied whistling duck open a car door and steal a cream cheese Danish.
Wow.
Okay. Oh. Okay. We've got 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There's 15. Obviously that. Lines can't cross. You're 1.5 each? It's two, and then that would be that. That would be 2, 3, 4, 5. You can't split between gnome bags. You have to go to the same one because you're 1.5 each. I think that's right.
Well, that wasn't so hard.
Oh, I can still talk to Steve.
How are you doing, Steve?
Okay.
See you, Steve. Hello, gentlemen. A bit early for a lunch break, isn't it?
Until the eraser factory opens again, Daryl and I have nowhere else to go.
Yeah, me and Daryl got nowhere else to go.
Wait.
That's great. Then you don't mind if I ask
Daryl and Daryl?
Yeah. As soon as I get these bugs back in place.
What? Why do you have bugs in a diner?
You gonna help or not?
Okay. Do they need to be three consecutive boxes? Three squares of territory. They each need two. Okay. I feel like that's that. Why didn't that work? Oh, right. Wait. Rules. Bugs of the same kind can share a box. Okay, so logically, why doesn't this work? Oh. Four-sided? Yeah, I think you're right. That's why it didn't work. Dang it. Alright. It was so close. So these guys are the problem. Well... Top right bad, yeah. Okay. So I probably had it, I just need to do this. Like, I probably thought about it too hard. Tried to block them all off. Wasting taxpayer dollars. Oh, man.
Oh, look at that! He did it!
Yes. Now, will you answer my questions?
Sure. Fire them at me.
2-1. Ugh. Ugh.
You two are employed at the factory. Would you say it's a safe place to work?
As safe as any other place, I guess.
As long as it's not run by Amazon.
The new wing is haunted.
No, it isn't. You better quit listening to those hippies.
Why do you think the new wing is haunted?
When the factory expanded, we built a new wing. A bunch of locals got angry. We had to clear out part of the forest to do it.
Because spirits live in the forest.
I'm sorry, what?
You mentioned something about spirits in the forest. Really?
Depends on who you ask.
You won't see me out in the woods after sundown.
Well, me neither. But there ain't no spirits.
Do you guys know what happened to the foreman?
Yeah, the lobster bit him.
Shut up, Daryl.
The lobster?
What do you mean a lobster bit him?
He means Mike Lobb. Mike and Isaac didn't get along all the time. Had a little bit of a fight.
That's because Isaac thought he was smarter than all of us floor guys.
Hell, he probably is.
No, he ain't. Just because he's a college boy don't make him smart.
That's true. That's very true.
What do you know about the guy fixing the sign outside?
Randall Scruffman. Weird guy. He thinks the trees talk to him.
Yeah, but he sure picked the right line of work. He's gonna be employed forever. Stuff always needs fixing.
I think he looks extra hard for stuff to fix around here.
Yeah, so he can be close to Glory. She's the waitress here. Sweeter than moose milk in the morning.
Thanks, gentlemen.
Anytime.
I guess we're talking to you now, right? Yep.
Excuse me, ma'am. Miss? Waitress lady?
Welcome to the Moose Ear Diner. I'll be right with you.
Can I help you with that?
Hang on a second. I'm looking at this area right here. There's no door or anything behind her, so is she just trapped behind the counter? Oh, there's the window. Okay. I was gonna say. What are we doing here? Fit all the food items on the plate in such a way that none of them overlap. Yeah. None of them overlap. Okay. This is a lot of stuff to put on one plate. Oh, is that like correct? So I guess they snap into place if I put them in the right spot. Okay, that's easy enough. Thankfully, they snap.
There you go. Delicious.
Thanks.
So, what's good here?
I don't know. It's all fine.
Oh, okay. What's your name?
Lori Davner.
Oh, So, I'm Nelson. Are you feeling okay?
Yes. No, I'm just thinking about my husband.
What's wrong with your husband, ma'am?
Oh, come on, okay? Stop being that guy.
Well, I'm with the FBI's Department of Puzzles Research. I need to ask you a few questions. An accident at the eraser factory caused it to shut down. Do you know anything about that?
Of course I do.
What have you heard?
Well, nothing really. I mean, just that it was an accident, like everyone says.
Mm-hmm.
The factory foreman, Isaac Davner. He was your husband?
Yes.
Oh, I'm so sorry. There's not much in my files about him.
That's okay. He's a great man. I'm so proud of him.
For?
Just so proud.
Oh, okay. The repairman outside seems a
bit odd.
She
doesn't seem like she's in shock at all.
Anything I should know about him?
Or denial or anything?
I think he's
totally
got a
normal.
Bit of a crush on me, but he's harmless.
Could he have hurt your husband to get to you?
Oh no. He wouldn't hurt a fly. He even avoids stepping on rocks so he won't accidentally hurt any critters living below. I wish people wouldn't tease him for that, Daryl.
Jerk.
Has the factory closure affected business?
Yeah. People tend to hang around here longer now that they aren't going to work. Normally, that'd be a good thing, but I've been pretty distracted.
You don't say.
Maybe I can help.
Nobody ordered a meal resembling their spouse. Oh boy. These are going to be some great art pieces, I'm sure. Oh, jeez. Okay. Fish lady. These are some... Nobody ordered a meal resembling their spouse. One lady ordered. Fish eating man sitting next to her. Only one patron. Okay. 4-1? My goodness. Alright. So I've got. Buffalo, onion, fish ham. And chicken split. We know that ham has to be next to the banana. Okay. Someone resembles their meal that they would have ordered it. That means they didn't get. Yeah. Okay. One lady ordered a meal resembling a fish-eating man. So, man-fish. Man-fish! Okay. That might be where we start. Man-fish. So, you could not have gotten it. So, either you or you got the fish. Right? Or... Hang on. One lady ordered a man, fish-eating man. Okay. So you didn't eat fish. Either you got fish or you got fish. So you got fish. No. Oh boy. This is just... I need to keep going back and forth between these because my brain's not functioning correctly. One lady ordered a meal resembling the fish-eating man. Man got a fish. Man got fish. So, either you got fish or you got fish. You got fish. You got onion rings. The ham plate should be set down next to the banana split. You didn't get ham. So, ham and banana. You didn't get... Oh. Alright, so the fish and the onion rings are out. mana. Alright, so you could not have gotten the chicken. You can't get the chicken. Hot ham water. You couldn't have gotten ham because the ham has to be next to the banana split. So you could be this, or no. You could be this or this. You can only be one of these two. You can only be one of those two. Fish lady might be the most frightening thing here. Even though onion guy is definitely weird. Just the look on her face. Alright, so you could not have gotten chicken. You could have gotten one of the other three. You could not have gotten fish, but we don't have to worry about that. You could have gotten that. That can't be right because I have to put these two together. And someone did get something that resembled them, so I could do... I think that works. The ham plate should be set down next to the banana split. Done. Only one patron resembles his or her meal. Oh, that's not done. Yes, it is done. That one's done. Okay. One lady ordered a meal resembling the fish-eating man sitting next to her. You ordered a meal of onions because the fish-eating man is sitting next to you. Nobody ordered a meal resembling their spouse. You don't have onions. You don't have ham. You don't have a banana split. And you don't have chicken. You don't have fish. And you don't have bison. What's the worst that I can do? Get it wrong? Yeah!
That wasn't so tough.
Yeah, huh.
I guess not.
Could I have a bit more of your time, ma'am?
Sure.
Finally gonna talk. Okay, everybody is up and going. I think we'll just talk to. Where are we at here? Alright.
Hello, Sheriff.
One more big puzzle, and then we're probably gonna do it, unless this gets me the gear.
Listen, I wanted to ask you.
No time. I got a hunch about the factory. I got security camera records here of people leaving the factory.
Good. It'd be helpful to talk with whoever left last.
Exactly what I was thinking.
Cheryl versus Daryl.
So we can put them back in the right order.
What? Why would you do that?
You know how it is.
No, I don't. That's evidence.
Okay. You left first because there are... And then this is two. This is three. This is four. Alright, there's no prints. You left. There are prints. You left. There are prints out this way. And then you went that way. And then the car disappeared, so... That seems correct. Yeah, just the order. That seems right. That seems right. That seems right. That seems right to me. Okay, that was not bad. Maybe we'll wait for a more challenging one.
This should clear things up.
Yeah. That seems about right. Looks like the
sheriff is so dumb, he's probably the mastermind.
You think he might have had something to do with the accident?
Probably. Why don't you head out to the ice fishing huts on Lake Sven's? When he's not working, he's usually there trying to dead stick a lunker.
Got it. No, wait. Do what to a what?
Catch some fish. He's got himself a bright orange vest. Can't miss him. Anyway, to get there, you can take the snowmobile out to Sesame Woods. But you'll have to hoof it from there.
Alright, let's push forward a little bit.
What do you know about Glory
Daffner? Foreman's wife. Poor girl, she's a sweet kid. Her family has lived in this town for generations.
Maybe she has something to do with the accident.
That's ridiculous.
It could be an insurance...
Now you just leave poor Glory alone. She's having a hard enough time without you getting all accusatory.
Looks like that whatever she's on, it's the good stuff.
What was the name of the factory worker I'm looking for?
The last guy to leave the factory was Mike Lobb. Drive out to Sesame Woods, then walk the trail out to the ice fishing huts.
Is there anything I should know about the Sesame Woods?
They've got the odd Wolverine in them.
What?
But that seems bad. Yes, my club. Not my club, my club. The most inaccurate gun in GoldenEye.
I better get back to it.
You betcha.
Any gum in here? I don't see any gum. 85. Is that gnome? He's armed. That was also an evil gnome. What the heck? What is happening?
The snow must be playing tricks on my eyes. For a second, I thought I saw... It doesn't matter. I'm on my way to question Mike Lobb at the...
Imagine how many puzzles I could solve if I was able to get one gun per month.
Sesame Woods. That doesn't sound dangerous at all.
Sesame Woods. Oh, that's... That was weird for this game. Okay. Like that.
Found Isaac Davner's ID badge. Looks like he came this way sometime before the accident. Why was Lobster, Mike Lobb, out here as well?
Not gonna pick that up. Also, this guy's frozen.
Hello?
Probably dead.
Ugh. I think I found Mike Lobb. Man, late 30s. Looks like he froze to death, trying to solve some sort of problem.
Oh, a puzzle, you say? Alright, maybe I will freeze to death. Alright, so I gotta get from here down to there, but I can't intersect a shadowy figure. I guess I can't. Oh no, I can turn them. That's weird. I need to. Yeah, that's gotta be that way. I just have to block off any possible way to get onto. That's going to be tricky. This square is a little rough. Alright, so here you're going to run into that guy. We can't go that way. I'll also run into that guy out. That is all safe. Okay, so we're gonna go here, we're gonna head down this way. We're gonna go here and through there. That is not connected. None of this is connected. This is also not connected. So I think that'll work.
Puzzle's gonna stop me in my tracks. Oh, sorry. I didn't mean.
They tried to take him.
You must be very cold.
Not
the lock on the factory door.
Key.
What is this thing? I think I found something important in the hands of a dead lobster. I'm going to hold on to it for later. The lake with the ice fishing huts is just past the clearing. I'm going to continue on to see if anyone there seems to have this affliction.
Okay. Game saved. I think I'm going to call it there. As much as I would like to keep going, I got stuff that I need to do. Like go to sleep. But yeah, this is not bad. This is much like Dynamite Jack last night. Pretty good. I think this is a game that I would continue playing at some point in the future. So, we'll, man. Taxpayers not happy. All that money. Okay, there's a good chunk of puzzles in here. There's some stuff going on. So, I've got to get stuff together for the pupper. So if you want to cash in any of your doggo treats, now it's the time to do it. How we doing? Doing all right?
We're doing all right.
Ha 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 ha. And a minute. Phone camera. Oh. Oh. Whoa. What's up, chat? Oh, I'm sorry. Did you hear something? To you? You sit? That's a girl. I cashed in a treat just for you. Time's ticking. Doggo cam can't stay on forever. Hi! He's definitely dodging. Look at my foot! Do you want another treat? Do you want another treat? Sit. Girl. All right, that is going to do it. I have no idea if the doggo cam is out of sync with everything else, but it doesn't matter.
Doesn't matter.
There's them jerky bites. Look at them.
Oh, all this stuff. Messy. Yes. Oh.
Oh, hey, it's the game. Wah.
Hi.
We done? Okay. Say goodbye, Addy. Close enough. All right. Boom. Boom. Thank you for tuning in, everybody. It's been another fantastic episode of Steam Cleaning. I will see you again tomorrow. That's right. Tomorrow. I said tomorrow with another game. Remember, 31 and 31 is not the same as 30 for 30. That's also not the same as one out of one. Take care, everybody. Good night.